Hi guys, in this video, we are going to learn how to pre-cut your applique fabric. So here is the fabric that I cut out, and you can see what it looks like once I stitch out the final applique here. And this is a technique that you can use to speed up your applique process. So you simply just take your applique design and you export an SVG file, which is what your cutting machines will read. And then when you load it into your cutting machines, you can prepare your applique fabric and it cuts it out beautifully. So in this video, we are gonna look at SewWhat-Pro as well as Embrilliance Essentials and see how you would make that SVG file and then load it in to your cutting machine and cut it out and then stitch out your applique. Here we are in SewWhat-Pro, and I've opened the my free Apple applique file, and we can see here, just by default, all of the thread colors. Now, if I click through them, I can quickly decipher which line is my placement line, this red one, and then the next blue one is my tack down line. So since they're the same, I could select either one of them, it doesn't matter. And then all I have to do is go to Tools and then the applique cutter. And you see here, now I'm going to have an SVG or a JPG file that is based on my Apple. So that's how I would do it. And here is how we can inflate. By default, it is 1, but we can make it larger if we want, 1.5 millimeters. If we want to, and then just hit save. And that's how I can get my SVG file that I can put in my cutting machine so that I can pre-cut my applique using SewWhat-Pro. So let's take a look at this applique file in Embrilliance Essentials. And we can see over here in the object view all of the different elements that make up our applique file. So I have a placement line and a tack down stitching line. Either one of them will work for my SVG file. So I'm just gonna select one and then I'm going to hit the color swatch associated with it. And when I do that, I see an applique tab. I click on it. I say this is the applique position, and then I have an option to save it out as an SVG file. And I have it inflated 1.5 millimeters. That's gonna be a little bit bigger than that tack down line, which is what we want. So I'm just gonna go ahead and save it. Here you can see that I've loaded my SVG file into my cutting machine software and my SewWhat cutting machine is now cutting out my applique fabric. Now I just need to peel away the excess fabric off of my sticky mat. To stitch out the applique design, first you need to load in the file and stitch out that first round of stitching, which is your placement stitching. This shows you where to lay down your applique fabric. Next, you want to carefully lay down that applique fabric so that you are covering that placement stitching line. And you want to make sure that you place it very evenly so that excess fabric hangs over the placement stitching equally around all sides. Next, you stitch down your tack down stitching line. This holds your applique fabric in place. Finally, you stitch out the final round of stitching, which is your satin stitching, and then your applique is done. So that is how you pre-cut your applique fabric and use that cutout fabric to create an applique project. Thanks for watching, and I'd love it if you liked and subscribed. See you later.